Good morning, guys. There we go. Light is on. And we are here live today. Happy Sunday. Turn it off. Happy Sunday to everyone. I know that all of you are home and hopefully you guys are all safe. Buongiorno a tutti e buona domenica a tutti, amici miei. So, ora saranno le 8:30 in Italia, spero tutto bene. Niente, grazie a tutti quanti per essere qui con me. Cominciamo a condividere, per piacere, su WhatsApp, mandatela a 10 persone e condividete su Facebook, perché oggi sarà una live molto, molto interessante. Andremo a fare un calzone originale, come lo fanno in pizzeria, a casa, e faremo l'origine, faremo, occhio sul forno, faremo il grande panuozzo, famoso, con salsiccia e fiorelli originali da Napoli. Quindi, condividete in tanti. Guys, today I'm going to show you how to make the real calzone Napolitan style in the house and the original panuozzo. It's the sandwich with the authentic rapini from Naples and homemade. Actually, it's not homemade, but we're gonna go ahead and cook the sausage. Yes, so let's wait. I just turn it on the oven. If you have oven, I turn it on the oven just to fire up some, to warm up the stone in the bricks for about, I turn it on 1 hour ago at the max temperature. So if you have an oven, just turn it on and ready to rock and roll. I'm gonna read some comments here. We are all live. Thank you so much for everybody to be here. Dan, Tors, Casa della Pizza, and everyone else. Guys, if you don't know how to share, I want to show you really quick. Really quick. You go here and right there. You go share and go WhatsApp, pump, and then choose all the contacts and send it. Like here, I'm going to send it right now to some people. Pom, pom, pom. There we go. Done. Send. Now that we did this, let's go ahead and see all the ingredients. Amici, andiamo a vedere cosa serve per gli ingredienti. Oggi I want to be action because we need some activity. We need some activity. So in this case, my case, and of your course, your case, if you follow me, we're going to cook. So we're going to cook in the authentic way. That's what we need today. There we go. We have a magical dough that I'm going to go tuck in a little bit. Abbiamo un bel impasto fatto ieri sera a casa con polish, 70%. Then we're gonna use some smoked mozzarella, one piece of garlic, of course, some nice sausage, una bella salsiccia, amici, se ce l'avete. There we go. Mozzarella fresca, pelato San Marzano, this is tomato sauce. Then we're gonna, I'm gonna show you how to make it too, really quick. Then we got this. I got a delivery from one of the best company here in Los Angeles. It's from Sonio Toscano. They deliver it to your house. Look at this, Sonio Toscano. They just sent me this amazing rapini. Those are authentic from Naples, guys. Questi qua vengono direttamente da Napoli. Cioè, non so se mi spiego. Sta scritto qui, product Fiorelli in oil. Amazing product of Italy. So if you don't have this, let's go ahead and use some broccoli, then some extra virgin olive oil, always from Sonio Toscano. They just delivered it to me yesterday. Amazing. Some sea salt, if you have pink, go ahead with pink, if you, and then some pepper. Hopefully you got everything. Comment here below. I'm gonna read a little bit. Is your burner one of your oven on top or the bottom? No, mine is just a simple oven. I just put it on the, is it, the heat comes out only from the bottom. Buonasera Vito, ho messo in pausa Netflix per vedere la tua diretta. Grande Leonardo, grazie, ti ringrazio, è un onore. Netflix è registrato. Ciao maestro, da quando ti seguo sarò ingrassato 20 kg, pure io. Ok. Andiamo e se siamo tutti pronti qui, andiamo e cominciamo la nostra ricetta. So, the first thing to do here is turn on the oven and let's warm up the stone or the bricks, whatever you have. Amici, accendiamo il forno alla massima temperatura, se l'abbiamo, e facciamo un po' di spazio per il nostro... dobbiamo andare a stendere e fare... La prima cosa da fare è cuocere la nostra salsiccia. Andiamo. Accendiamola alla massima, alla metà della temperatura, un po' di olio, via qui. Giusto un po', sennò affumichiamo tutta la casa. Video, grazie. Ok, perfect. Now, let's get the sausage. Let's give it a little cut. Just a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and cook three homemade sausage. Actually, let's do four. You know what? I'm gonna do it all. Give it a little cut. Now, wash my hands. There we go. Now let's go, and we're gonna put our sausage just right there. There we go. Okay, now that we have the sausage done, let's close the lid very low. Number three. Hopefully we don't burn the kitchen this time. Last time I almost burned the kitchen down. Okay, so now let's get the sauce. I want to show you how to make the sauce really quick. This is how I make the sauce in my house. Amici, ecco come facciamo il pomodoro per la pizza. Cioè, molto facile. Questo è il pomodoro, l'abbiamo rotto con le mani. We break the, by hands the tomato. And now, with just a little bit of pinch of salt. A little more. This is the same how I make in my pizza place. Little bit of olive oil. Done. And we get a little bit of basil. But the basil, we have to break it by hands. Because when you break it, you get some little bit of olive oil from the basil. And it gets mixed up with the sauce. Done. This is how I make the sauce. Ecco come facciamo il pomodoro. Okay guys, so the first thing that we're gonna do here is the panuozzo. Amici, ora stiamo facendo il nostro panuozzo autentico con la salsiccia e friarelli. Quindi abbiamo messo a cuocere la salsiccia, non la tocchiamo. Quando la salsiccia diventa cotta anche da sopra un po', cioè che abbiamo visto il colore che cambia un po' da sopra, allora andiamo e la giriamo al contrario. Non la vogliamo cuocere tutta completamente, perché dopo l'andiamo a mettere, il nostro panuozzo lo andiamo a mettere nel forno. Quindi, ecco qui, andiamo e parliamo un attimino del nostro impasto. Let's talk about, where can I find your recipe, Vito? On my channel. I want to talk a little bit about this dough in the meantime that is cooking the sausage. Okay, this dough is made... basically this morning at 8 o'clock, but before I prepare the Polish is basically the yeast I made. I put 300 grams of water, 300 grams of flour, and 6 grams of dry yeast. Then I let it rest overnight at room temperature. This morning I add the water, the flour, and the salt. And look at this. Look. Niente, amici, questo qua è un semplice impasto. È un semplice impasto. Have you ever worked with instant yeast? Yes, I worked with instant yeast. Also, I'm coming out with some mother yeast, which is this one. This is mother yeast. Lievito madre, ragazzi, fatto da me. Ieri ho fatto il pane. Yesterday I made some bread. And this is the bread that I made with mother yeast. Ecco il pane fatto con lievito madre di ieri. Sto cercando di girare un video, ma veramente complicato. Eccolo qua. Questo è il pane. Come potete vedere, molto soffice, ancora di ieri. Was made yesterday with Mother East. Done with this. Ieri tua madre si dice sourdough. Well, Mother East or sourdough, I believe is the same thing. Let's put it in the fridge. Okay, the sausage is almost done. Can I go ahead and flip it over? There we go. I can show it to you. This point, we're gonna go ahead and flip it over. There you go. Now, go ahead and let it cook more. The reason why I covered the sausage is this way, the sausage here cooks much better. So now we're gonna go ahead and make the panuozzo. So, andiamo e facciamo il nostro panuozzo. Eccolo qua. Forno acceso alla massima temperatura. Accendiamo. Let's fire up the oven at the max temperature. There we go. Look at the dough. Oh my God. I mean, you can see the dough. Wow. If I make a pizza napoletana with this, it's gonna come out amazing. Actually, if we have time, I'm gonna make a pizza too. So this one is for the panuozzo in the flour. Couple of times. Don't touch it too much. Make sure to close the dough. Chiudiamo il nostro impasto, se no si secca. Otherwise it's gonna get dry. And let's put it on the side. Now we don't need it. Right here. No? Okay, this is the panuozzo. We're gonna go ahead and cut the dough in half. Ripeto, questo è il panuozzo originale. Ora andiamo e con la mano, so with the hands, go ahead and lo allarghiamo così. Okay, guys, we don't want to take off all the air from the authentic panuozzo. Eh? There you go. Wow. Okay, guys, we don't want to take off all the air, so we're going to go ahead and gently, don't press, just like that. Then we're going to stretch gently to make it a little bit bigger. You just pump these little bubbles. Panuozzo is a very simple simple sandwich that we make in Italy, almost everywhere now. So now let's go ahead. Did you see it's face up? So this is how was the ball. The ball was like this in the container. So now we put in the face up. Attenzione a come ho messo il nostro panuozzo, eh? Girato così. Andiamo a metterci un po' d'olio sopra. A little bit of olive oil on top. Just like this. Tan, 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 tan. Now, let's put a little bit of pepper. I like to put pepper, but if you like oregano, the original one is somebody put pepper, somebody put oregano. Oh, also, you know what you can do? You can also put a little bit of salt, not too much though. Done. There we go, let's check. Let's check the sausage. Okay, now it's cooking. I'm gonna put the cut part on the bottom. There we go. Still cooking. Right there. Now, let's go ahead and let's cook the panuozzo. So let's get the peel. You can pinch it and you can put it on top. Very easy. Or if you don't have a peel, let's go ahead be careful when you get some dropped off of the olive oil. Okay, now let's go ahead. Let's put it in the oven at the max temperature. Like you can see, I put it right there. Okay, let's clean up the counter. Make sure it needs to be way always clean, because the part where you're going to stretch the dough, it needs to be nice and dry. Otherwise, if you get a little bit of water, a little bit of olive oil, the dough will stick and you get the dough and stick. What if you don't have a peel? Oh, easy. That's a good question. You get a sheet pan, you flip it over. Let me get it to you, show you. You get some sheet pan like this, you put it on top, you go in the oven and use it as a sheet pan. Or you just put it on top of this and you put it in the oven. What temperature? The oven is at the max temperature, is at 500. Let's check it out. We don't want to touch it. We don't want to open the oven at all. It's going to finish the... Let's check it out, the sausage. Amazing. Let me show it to you. I'll show it to you, the sausage. Take a look. They are face down. This is a fennel sausage. Let's keep it on. Now we need a little grill like this one. If you don't have it, it's okay. This is for our panozzo. So now, at this point, let's get some mozzarella or some smoked mozzarella, whatever you have. Then our amazing friarelli. Vito, can you ship this panozzo to Germany, please? Maybe. In the future. Guys, let's leave a thumbs up and thank you so much for being here. Grazie, amici, per essere qui. Is that classic salsiccia? This is a fennel sausage. So let me read right here. There we go. I'm going to read some comments to you. In the meantime, we have panozzo cooking. Wow. They're popping out, because what do you want on the panozzo? They pumps out really, really nice. Ok, Vito, avendo schiacciato i bordi del panetto, l'aria dov'è rimasta? L'aria, quello, quando se lo mettiamo nel forno alla alta temperatura, il panozzo vedrai che si gonfia alla massima temperatura, si gonfia come un palloncino. Quindi c'è sempre l'aria. Però non bisogna schiacciarlo proprio tutto, bisogna, come hai visto nella... quando l'ho steso. Saluto Vito, come va lì? Alessio è so best pizza store, traveling time 398. What is the model of the oven? This is a frigidaire. Vito, aspettiamo con ansia il video su pizze e sgagliozze. Bari nel cuore sempre. Buongiorno a tutti, amici. Buongiorno, andiamo a vedere. Ecco qua, sì. Amazing. I'm gonna go ahead and get it just to show it to you. How it's coming out, you see? I'm gonna turn it a little bit and change a little bit of spot. Andiamo, è ora. Wow, smells good. Wow, amazing. Thank you so much. Grazie, grazie Rudy, faccio il suo impasto pizza oggi, adesso. Grazie Rudy per la donazione, amazing donation, thank you so much. Grazie. Andiamo e giriamo ancora una volta le nostre salsicce. Ok, I want to say something. When you cook, amazing, thank you so much for the donation. English, Rose, best show. Thank you, Vito. Please give for your family in Italy. And much love. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Grazie, Vinzo. Vincent Romano, gracias Vito, your recipe and tips are the best, my friend. And family, thank you so much, my friend. Thank you so much for the donation. Ok, amici, andiamo a vedere. Quasi pronto. Andiamo, non vogliamo cuocerlo tutto alla massima, non vogliamo cuocerlo tutta la via, diciamo, il nostro panozzo. Eccolo qua, pronto. Andiamo a prendere. Opa. There we go. That's one. Like you can see, it's not cooked all the way. It's not cooked all the way because because we're gonna go ahead and finish the panuozzo in the oven. But if you don't want to finish it in the oven, you can go ahead and finish. You can go ahead and cook it all the way. Amici, non abbiamo cotto tutto la... caldissimo. Non abbiamo cotto tutta la via, però. Perché ora andremo, vi faccio vedere come lo finiamo il nostro panuozzo. Ok, andiamo, prendiamo un coltello, ecco qua, che pescare. Let's put the sausage on one side because the sausage is almost ready. Yeah, sausage is almost ready. Now we're gonna go ahead and cut the panuozzo. Be careful because this panuozzo inside is hot air, so you can easily burn with the hot air. So we're gonna go ahead gently and cut it, or you can have some hold it with. Ecco qua, amici, attenzione a non bruciarvi perché questa è la parte dove vedi questo vapore, questo. Facile da bruciarli, quindi andiamo. Molto caldo. La ragione perché lo sto tagliando caldo è perché proprio in questo momento andiamo a... voilà, voilà. Amazing. Ok, ora andiamo e mettiamo la nostra mozzarella in questo modo dentro il nostro panuozzo. This one is save it for later for me. You can also save the panuozzo just like this. You wrap it up, you put it in the fridge, or you put it in the freezer, and this is good for maybe 2-3 weeks. O potete anche congelare se non lo usate. Ok, ecco qui, andiamo e prendo la nostra salsiccia. Let's put a little bit of olive oil on top. One second. There we go. Some pepper. Now let's get the sausage. There we go. Wow. Wow. Friends and family, here you go. The sausage, amazing, juicy, wow. If you don't have sausage, you can use something else. Let's go ahead, take off, let's put it right here down, face down. Ripeto, questa è la classica. Ok, now, è la classica cuccia o panuozzo napoletano. Ok. Let's cool down the sausage. Now, with the same olive oil of the sausage, because I like this, we go ahead and just warm up a little bit the rapini, but those are already... This is how you open a can. These are already pre-made to show you really quick how beautiful they are. So, you can also not warm it up because they already cook and put it in the olive oil. Wow, look at this. Amazing. But in the meantime, I like it warm a little bit. So, and mix with the olive oil of the sausage. There we go. Okay, you put a little bit inside, as much as you want, in the
your panuozzo.
Let's close it. Once it's open, you have to save it in the fridge.
I'm gonna warm it up to max temperature.
1. Now let's wait. Warms up a little bit. Now let's go ahead and let's cut the sausage. You can cut it just like that. Or you can cut it on the long way. As you prefer, it's not really important. This is the sausage that we're gonna make, and we're gonna put it in the panuozzo. But make sure this is the original one is cut just like that. There you go. I'm gonna read your comments in a little bit. Leggerò un po' I commenti tra un po'. Ecco qua, abbiamo la salsiccia già tagliata. Saltiamo i nostri rapini. Let's save that there and let's finish our panuozzo. There we go. Quando la salsiccia è ancora calda, andiamo e mettiamola sul panuozzo. Wow, mi sta venendo fame, amici. A little bit of juice. There we go. Now, let's go ahead and let's put the rapini in the other half. This is the rapini. Don't get too much olive oil. Let's squeeze it a little bit. Not too much. And then, let's go ahead and let's put the rapini just on top of the panuozzo. Wow, man, you don't even know how this smells. You can't imagine. Done. Ok, ecco qui il nostro panuozzo. Amazing, another donation. Let me read it. Thank you so much, Robert. Help easily save it this one day by learning to veto make dough from you. Thank you so much for the donation, and the panuozzo is done halfway. So now we're gonna go ahead and put it in the oven again at the max temperature. Andiamo, mettiamolo nel forno così com'è. Alla massima temperatura. Ecco qua. Now that we have amazing, another donation. Thank you so much, Sebastiano. Fino un piccolo pensiero per te, maestro. Grazie, grazie so much. Sebastiano, okay, wow, it's getting hot, getting hungry, my stomach is getting, so now the oven is, the panuozzo is in the oven, and I can't wait to taste it, amici, cioè non voi neanche potete immaginare l'odore che ha, cioè, fantastico, oh my god, just noticed you have the pizza tattoo, yes, this is by my Michael Mazzone, my friend from Bari. This is panuozzo, yes. Thank you so much for your video, I learned so much. Thank you, master, thank you. Vito, sono più fischi in questa live che Fiera Rutiliana. Grande, grazie. Stay hello to Brazil. Ciao, Brazil. Do you watch MotoGP? Yes, I do. So, let's get back. With... Okay. So, the panuozzo is in the oven. We have to melt the cheese. When the cheese is melted, oh my god, the panuozzo is ready to taste. And after, in a little bit, we're gonna go ahead and make the real calzone in the house. I know a lot of people have been asking for this calzone. Come va la vita? It's okay. So. Siamo tutti a casa, eccoci qui. Mozzarella si sta sciogliendo. Ho salvato un po' di salsiccia perché nel nostro calzone andremo a mettere un po' di salsiccia. Ok, guys. This is the panuozzo that I saved. Now it's cold, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you how to save it. Let's get some
plastic wrap. Scherzo. Sapete, si possono congelare. Una volta cotti, si possono congelare. Ecco qua, spieghiamo, senza tanta fatica. Voilà. Ed ecco qua il nostro panosso, lo possiamo salvare. Now we can go ahead and put it in the freezer or in the fridge. And this is good for 2 or 3 weeks. Like you can see, time of the year, just like this, we have to save everything, guys.
Save everything because we don't know what is going to happen.
So now, let's get the sausage here.
We're going to go ahead and make the calzone. Calzone is a little bit more complicated because you have to make it fast.
Il calzone a casa è un po' più complicato perché bisogna farlo veloce. The panozzo bread is made from pizza dough? Yes. If you can see the live from the beginning, you'll see
this is the dough that we used for the panozzo.
There we go.
So now let's go ahead.
And I'm going to talk a little bit also about frozen dough or not. There are mozzarella? Yes. Where the pizzeria is located? The pizzeria is on Melrose Avenue.
Okay. Nostro panozzo.
Oh, ho! Fermi tutti! Stop right there! Don't move! Non muovetevi. Lasciate un like e il panozzo sta per uscire. Sta per uscire.
Siete pronti?
Wow! Wow!
Take a look
of this panuozzo. Ragazzi, abbiamo Napoli a casa vostra. We have Naples in your house. This is what I like. Now, let's go ahead. Let's close it. Like you can see, the bread here now is a little bit more crunchy. Now, one shot. On 3, 2, 1, pam! Voilà! Ed ecco qua il panuozzo napoletano. Now, let's transfer this. Ready? Let's put it right there. Done. Now, I want you to hear the crunches of the panuozzo. Here we need a big knife. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. I mean, you tell me. Give me a vote. This is the authentic calzone. This is the authentic panuozzo napoletano, salsiccia ferrelli and regular cheese.
Come out amazing. I'm gonna give a little bite because today I'm gonna eat the calzone and this is for my family really. It's waiting for me. Can't wait.
Cotto al punto giusto, amici, provatela a casa perché è fantastico, fantastico. Lo metto nel piatto. Mettiamolo nel piatto e andiamo a fare il nostro calzone.
Man,
this is good. I love to cook. I have this passion. You can present it just like that. Done. I mean, take a look at this plate. This panuozzo. That's amazing. Look. And it's really good cold. Better than sex. Yes. Yes. Food. Making love with the food is the best, guys. Especially when you make it. When you make it, you are giving a little bit more value of the flavor. You'll see.
Try this home. I'm here with you. I'm here for you to show you how to make the best authentic food from Italy, from scratch, here. Amen.
Eccolo qua. Andiamo e facciamo il nostro calzone. Mettiamo al lato. Prepariamoci. There we go. Done.
Now, this is very simple. We need to make it fast. Maybe 2 to 3 minutes to make it. Okay. Make sure, learn this, amici. Quando fate la pizza, dovete pulire benissimo il bancone, se no si attacca. Guardate qua. This, the dough will get stuck. So we need to go ahead and clean it really well. Don't put too much flour when you stretch. Non usate tanta farina, amici, perché la farina bruciata fa male. Come ve lo devo dire? Ma lo dico in inglese perché in America, cioè, questo è un errore che fanno parecchi e pensano che la farina sotto bruciata dà sapore. Non voglio dire parolacce. Guys, the flour under the pizza burn, well, it's not good for you. You want to understand that? It's not good for you. When it burns the flour, it's cancerogenic. I mean, it's not good. You have to make the pizza with no flour. I'm here. Check out my channel and you'll learn that. I love your program. I have to eat before I watch to go crazy. Amazing. Okay, let's go ahead and let's make the calzone. Done. There we go. This is the dough. Amici, stiamo per fare il calzone. Attenzione, attenzione, condividete, lasciate un bel like. Vito, quando è uscito il panuozzo sembrava un uovo in camicia. Sei magistrale, grazie. Quando è l'ultima live che seguo, altrimenti mi mangio pure la mia socia. Grande. Buy a pizza still. I have that. I love the bricks, those bricks. Because the bricks are amazing. Look so good. Thank you so much. I'm gonna read some comments, don't worry about. So you please comment. Ciao. Mio, sei un grande. Grazie, grazie. Okay, andiamo a fare il calzone. Guys, pay attention because we're going to do it in one shot and this one, it's very simple. Let's put some flour on top. Look at the dough. Look at the dough. Wow! Done. Ecco qua. Andiamo. It's cut on one side. So the ball need to be just like that. You cannot touch it too much or like this or like this because it will make the dough really hard to stretch. Let's get some flour on the spatula. Let's pinch it. Let's go one shot. Pump. Don't be scared. It's the dough that needs to be scared of you. It's the dough that needs to be scared of you, not you of the dough. Is that clear? Yes. Yes. This is the dough. Couple of times. Man, so soft. Touch it gently. Toccate l'impasto con delicatezza, come se toccate una donna, amici. Così, gently. Let's close the door. Voilà. Voilà. Let's put it on one side. Okay, when you make pizza or when you make calzone, it doesn't matter what, you need to have space. And you need to have everything ready. Tomato sauce, the cheese, or whatever you're gonna put in the calzone. So in this case, I'm gonna put some sausage, some smoked mozzarella, and some tomato sauce. Okay, let's go ahead and let's stretch the dough, but make sure touch it really gently because this is my baby. This is my wife. Wow. Did you see? I take off the flour. I don't have any flour. Not too much, not too little. Okay, let's go. Let's see. It is safe to use my roller pin. My God, these guys. Remove this comment. There we go. The dough is not as... anyway. Avito, I always watch your videos. Okay, let's go ahead and let's stretch the dough. So, when you make a calzone, don't touch the center right now. So, we go ahead, like this, your hands like this, amici, ecco qua, togliamo tutta l'aria da dentro il calzone, dei lati, così, ora la giriamo, avete visto questo movimento? Abbiamo una mano qui e una mano qui e la capovolgiamo, pam. Ora pressiamo con più forza, let's press. Now again, one more time. We are taking off all the air to the calzone. Pam, 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 pam. Pam, 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 pam. Okay, just press. And my wife is gonna kill me now, all this flour everywhere. Okay, now the dough. One more time, just like this. This was the top of the face, the top of the balls. So the top of the balls needs to go down. Okay, at this point, when we have the calzone, we have to go fast. So let's go ahead, let's put the smoked mozzarella, oven at the max temperature, smoked mozzarella only in one side, see? Done. Now let's get the sausage, and the sausage, we need to break it. I love to break the sausage. The sausage needs to be cold. Everything that goes inside the calzone needs to be cold. Tutto ciò che va dentro al calzone, amici, deve essere freddo, se no andiamo a riscaldare la nostra pasta e si bucherà. Wow! Done. Not too much, not too low. Let me wash my hands. There we go, there we go. Almost there, almost there. Now, let's put a little bit of pepper. In Naples, they put ricotta and chicory. Here, we don't have it. So you can make it as the one you want. Have I mai visto sti cose a Napoli? Nagi, mai visto sti cose a Napoli? Allora, questo ti spiego subito. Spieghiamo subito un attimino questo commento a Stefano. Stefano, allora, siamo a casa, ovviamente ci adeguiamo con gli ingredienti che abbiamo a casa. Questo è un calzone autentico napoletano, sono 15 anni che lo faccio, a Napoli, in provincia e in tutto il mondo. E quindi va fatto con la, ovviamente a Napoli lo fanno con la ricotta, mozzarella e qualcuno mette il cotto, qualcuno mette i cicoli, quindi quello, oggi abbiamo la mozzarella affumicata e la salsiccia. Quindi ecco qui, io vi sto dimostrando come fare il calzone, non abbiamo ancora finito. Quindi a me piace un po' di tumero sasso, un po' di salsa dentro, un po' di mozzarella fresca sopra, io, ecco qua, ora andiamo e chiudiamo, così, questo modo. Now we're gonna close it, here we go. Now, when you wanna put too much, you don't wanna put too much flour, so gently put your hands in the flour, mettiamo la mano nel... E questo qua, non so se l'avete mai visto, lo schiaffetto per buttare un po' di farina. Andiamo e accappottiamolo sulla nostra farina. E ora lo chiudiamo, così. Let's get the, spinge it a little bit. And now, let's go ahead and let's close it. Ok, ora, dai lati, non andate troppo forte, giriamolo così. Se è appiccicato, andiamo di nuovo e mettiamo un po' di farina così, questo lato lo mettiamo sulla nostra farina, ecco qua. Ora vi consiglio di prendere la pala, ovviamente la pala è sporca, andiamo a pulire, ecco qua la nostra pala, di nuovo let's get the hands in the flour and voilà. Now let's pinch on one side, let's go ahead and put it on top. Quick! Ecco qua, il nostro calzone. Andiamo e rompiamolo. E a questo punto andiamo a mettere il nostro pomodoro sul calzone. Okay, now we go ahead and let's put the calzone. Don't put it, see, when it goes on the peel, I'm doing this just to make it easy for you. Sto facendo queste cose per farvi vedere la più facile maniera possibile. Andiamo, mettiamo un po' di farina dove è andato il nostro pomodoro e cerchiamo di togliere il pomodoro dalla pala. Ecco qua. Ok, guys. Done. Then I like to put a little bit of basil on top where the hole was and a little bit of cheese on top if you want to put the cheese. If you don't want to, don't worry. Now let's go ahead, let's put some olive oil. There we go. Little bit of pepper. But this one, this step needs to be really fast. Okay, now, very important, go ahead and make sure it's not sticky. So if it's stick, I did this in purpose, I repeat, ho fatto questo apposta. Mettiamo un po' di farina, little bit, and let's put the calzone on the counter. Now, don't panic. With your finger, get all the tomato sauce out from the calzone. Amici, sto facendo questa apposta per dimostrarvi cosa succede nei casi peggiori. Quindi con la spatola andiamo e andiamo a togliere tutta la salsa dal nostro calzone. There we go. Ok, a questo punto, little bit of flour. And let's go ahead, one shot, then we go in the oven. Really quick. Square. One shot. There we go. Calzone, it's in. Like you can see, the calzone, it's very, very difficult to make at the house because you need to be fast. So, but try, and then you're going to go ahead and make the calzone amazing, really good. Guys, we are 400 people. Please. Let's leave a big like, thumbs up. This way, automatically, you will share to your page. Now, let's check out really quick. The oven needs to be really, really hot. Now, at this point, we don't touch it anymore. When it gets a little bit brown and gold, we can go ahead and turn it and flip it on the other side or move it around. But don't touch the calzone or you're going to go ahead and make the hole. So, for the new people, we just made the panuozzo. Now it's cold. Wow. I have to go eat. Yes, go for it. Now, let's clean up the counter because I'm gonna go ahead and show you to you the calzone. Okay, let's stop. I'm gonna go ahead and reply to some comments. There we go. Okay. We need something like this. Okay, guys, let me read some comments. You are Barese. Come shame, tutta post. Nice, great. Looks amazing. I will make tonight. As always, perfect. Maestro Vito, secondo te è meglio usare una semolina anziché farina per lavorare la pasta della pizza?
Sì, perché io ho usato la semolina. Controlliamo sempre il nostro calzone, si sta gonfiando appena appena, però l'abbiamo rotto perché non vogliamo che esplode e poi tutto esce dai lati.
It looks, Vito, ci voleva una bella perone da avere. Boh.
Ok,
the Huni Pro is $600 at the moment, I think, and it looks very, yes, not bad. Hello from Baltimore. When do you premiere on Food Network? Whenever they call me. Where you bought the pills, sir?
These pills are from Huni, they give it to me. But honestly, I use also G-Metal. G-Metal is one of the best pills ever. And let's check out the calzone. Calzone is cooking there. Amazing. It cooks about 4 to 5 minutes.
Italian dough bricks all together. Yes. Di dove? Sì, precisamente. Bari? No, sono di Torre a Mare. Torre a Mare.
Attenzione. Quando sentiamo un po' di... nel forno. Ok.
Andiamo un attimino indietro. Uso, invece, se voi avete notato, usiamo i mattoncini perché la pietra unica si rompe.
quando va un po' di pomodoro sopra, pum, si spacca. Non so se avete notato quello, avete avuto quel problema. Io l'ho avuto, quindi i mattoncini non si spaccano, andate tranquilli perché sono più doppi e tengono la temperatura molto più alta. Quindi let's go ahead, again, shake it out. Calzone is cooking nicely. The oven is at the max temperature. If you guys have any some question, oh, you know what? Let's talk about the dough. There we go. Okay. Guys, this is the dough that I made. Ramana, spiego un attimino questo in inglese, così mi capiscono. Prima loro. E poi lo spiegherò in italiano. Guys, this is the dough that I made yesterday. Now you can see it's ready at the point to be used. So now, because I'm not going to use it, because, you know, I don't have 20 people here, but I have three balls. So what I do now, I go ahead and freeze it. I can freeze the dough. Yes, just like that. Freeze. Then, if you want to use it, when you're going to use it, let's say after tomorrow or whatever, next Sunday, I want to make pizza. Go at night, Saturday night, you go ahead and get the dough out and put it in the fridge. That's it. The dough is perfect, goes in temperature. Then you take it out from the fridge, goes in temperature 1 hour, and ready to use, just like that. Provano a fare stu piatti, ma do annate. Ce la fanno, ce la fanno. Italian French watching from UK. Amazing. Guys, stay all safe. Ok, spiego questo in italiano. Amici, l'impasto, ovviamente, quando avanza, non andate a buttarlo, non vi agitate, potete tranquillamente congelarlo. Così come sta, andiamo e lo mettiamo nel freezer. Ecco qua. Ovviamente, non mettete niente sopra, don't put anything on top, put it in a flat base. Lo congeliamo e mettiamo che domenica prossimo vogliamo fare le pizze. Sabato sera lo prendete dal freezer, lo spostate nel frigorifero. Dopodiché, la mattina dopo, tipo vogliamo fare le pizze a pranzo, usciamo l'impasto un'ora prima, lo facciamo andare a temperatura, l'impasto, voilà, avete un impasto come fatto da poco tempo fa ed è pronto. Quindi, spero che sia chiaro. The ball has how many grams? The dough balls are 260 grams. Seminiamo compagnia per questa quarantena. Grazie. Stay home. Giuseppe, grazie. Anche per me, voi siete di compagnia.
Ecco qua il nostro calzone. La mozzarella sta cadendo, quindi che facciamo? Lo spostiamo, ma non sulla mozzarella. Attenzione. There we go. Come potete vedere, abbiamo un po' di mozzarella sulla pietra. Non spostate il calzone o la pizza, quello che è, sulla mozzarella, sennò quella si andrà ad attaccare all'impasto e formeremo un buco, oppure c'è un po' di fumo. Devo accendere la cappa qui. Spero che mi potete sentire. E formerete un buco, oppure la dobbiamo andare a buttare. Guys, if you get some mozzarella on the floor of the base where you have the pizza or the calzone, Vito, fai venire a lavorare da te, faccio il pizzaiolo d'Altamura. Grande, ti vengo a trovare. I was saying that if you get, don't put the pizza or the calzone on top of the cheese, otherwise it's gonna stick and then we're gonna go ahead and throw it away. Vito, cosa cambia nel mettere nell'impasto della pizza il lievito di birra o quello secco? Il lievito secco è più forte. Tutto qua, cioè, puliamo la nostra pala. Ecco qua, il nostro calzone si sta cuocendo. Vabbè, che ve lo dico a fare? Siamo in pizzeria, uno qui ha scritto che non ha mai visto queste cose a Napoli, purtroppo questo è un calzone napoletano, autentico, non so, io sono pizzaiolo, lo faccio, lo so. What do you think about American pizza? Not so good. Because they don't make it really well. Ciao Vito, sei un grande, grazie. Toris, my smoke alarm. Yes, it is. So I had to turn on the fan. Hi Vito, from Athens, can you give me a proportion from Napoli pizza with Polish 6 pizza? Check out my channel, because today this video is about pizza panozzo and the calzone. We are almost done with the calzone. Please, guys, leave a thumbs up. I appreciate to all the people that has been here, comment, and they like, and thank you so much. Saluti da Napoli, sei un grande. Grazie, Michele. Un abbraccio. Un abbraccio a te da Los Angeles. What is your favorite cheese to use for pizza calzone? Smoke mozzarella. Sausage name? Fennel sausage. I don't know, I throw away the bag. How do you think clean the bricks? How do you clean the bricks? That's a good question. Thank you so much. Nati, you let it burn completely, the cheese or the tomato sauce. Burn it black. Then when it's cold, you cool down. When it's cold, you scrape it out with the spatula, with a metal spatula. Scrape it out and that's it. Very simple. Vorrei comprare un lì. Non male. Ma è meglio la biga o il polish o tusili? A casa e nel business vai con il polish. Poi se dipende dall'impastatrice che hai, io andrei con la biga, se hai una spirale, che va veloce. Ecco qua, il nostro calzone è quasi pronto. Come... Peccato non posso farvi vedere, non ho ancora la telecamera, ma ci sta un po' di mozzarella che è andata a finire sui nostri mattoncini. Quindi volevo spiegarmi un po', però mi sto organizzando con la telecamera. Se dopo la quarantena di venire in America a mangiare la pizza da te. Smoke là. Dobbiamo aprire un po' là, la finestra. Sta andando tutto a fuoco, amici, tutto a fuoco, attenzione. Ecco qua, apriamo un po' la finestra, la porta, ecco qua. Così un po' di... non è fumo, ma è il calore. Però ci arrestano. Calzone pronto. Ecco qua. Voilà. Wow. Lower down, there we go. Amazing. Guys. Questo è il calzone autentico napoletano a casa. Guys, I mean, you look at this. This is a real calzone at the house. Amazing, soft and crunchy in the same time. I never show this to my channel. Check it out the bottom. Cook nicely, perfectly. Now let's gonna go ahead and we're gonna cut it. Voilà. There we go. Now it's too hot, but I'm gonna go ahead and cut the dough. Like you guess, it's very crunchy, easy to cut. Wow, nice and smoky, soft, crunchy in the same time. I mean, now show me your love, leaving a like here. And amazing, guys. This one was amazing. Nice and fresh. Wow, it was too hot. Turn it off. Okay, I'm gonna turn it off the oven. The oven is off. The bricks are the mozzarella they fall down on the top. It's a little bit burnt. It's getting burnt. Attenzione con la porta aperta. Mo entra qualcuno ti frega il calzone. Yes, io ho già cenato, mamma mia, sì, è vero, no, dovevo chiudere qua, perché somebody can get in and saw my food. Per fortuna vivo in un complesso qui a Los Angeles. You are true master, man, come on, I'm hungry and good now. So, Vito, per favore, chiudi la porta, la sto chiudendo. Ecco qua il nostro calzone, come potete vedere, bello cotto al punto giusto. Ovviamente, come a tutti i miei video, andrò ad assaggiare. Madonna, mamma. Wow! Try this at home. Sapete qual è il colmo di un pizzaiolo? Non lo dico, I'm not gonna say this in English, because in English we don't have colmo. We don't have this says. Il colmo di un pizzaiolo è bruciarsi con un panzerotto. Perché... quando dai un morso, c'è il vapore che esce, che ti brucia, quindi bisogna stare attenti. Vito, per il prossimo live farai una ricetta per la pizza? Sì, sì, questo è un buon commento, grazie. al prossimo live faremo la pizza romana a casa, la pizza autentica in pala a casa. Guys, next video, next live streaming, probably on Thursday or Sunday, I'm gonna go ahead and make the pizza romana style at the house. Nothing. We are done here. I want to wish you an amazing Sunday. Stay home. Unfortunately, we have to be home and all together and nothing. I'm here to try to entertain you with some food. That's all I can do. Hopefully, this one is nice for you. And nothing. I'll see you at next Tuesday. I'm publish the new video about the sandwiches that I made. Nice, the buns, Tuesday. Amici, grazie a tutti per essere qui con me. Vi ringrazio tantissimo. So che siamo tutti a casa. Io cerco nel mio meglio di intrattenervi tramite il mio canale. Se avete qualche domanda, se avete qualche cosa, qualche video che volete che faccio, io lo faccio. My God. Grazie. Thank you so much, guys. I'm about to leave. If I give you like 4 or 5 minutes to read some comments and stay together and vuoi assaggiare?
Stai bruciando la cucina?
No, tutto a posto. Vieni. Assaggio, questo è per te. Così fai sentire ai nostri colleghi qui. No, non ti preoccupare, non ti vede nessuno. Vieni.
No, lo assaggio dopo.
Assaggi dopo, va bene. Una bomba è venuta. Vieni, andiamo, vieni. Vieni. Ok, guys, I'm gonna... One second, I'm gonna answer to all your questions. Mi potresti leggere un po' di domande che così commentiamo? Vieni qua. Vieni. There we go, buongiorno. Che c'è? Quella pizza. She wants some pizza? Just wake up. Hi, Vito, can you please make a video about farina Manitoba? I can't, because... Che è successo? Che sta succedendo? Quella pizza? Unfortunately, pizza Manitoba, the Manitoba flour, I cannot find it. Che c'è qua? Quella pizza, guarda. Che c'è qua? Hai visto? Buongiorno a tutti. Ciao a tutti. La pizza. Che c'è? Quella pizza calda. Nothing, guys. Also, this week I'm opening a new channel for her. Yeah, pizza. So I will. Hopefully, you guys can go ahead and subscribe to their channel if you have kids. La pizza vuoi, papà? Che? Non trovo. She wants pizza. There we go. No, non è caldo. There we go. Okay, guys, like, comment, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much, Vincent. You are the best. Okay, guys, thank you so much to everyone. Ho detto che rileggevo un po' di domande, ma non le ho lette. Che farina usi? Uso la Molino Piantoni 00. Il forno che sta davanti al mare, faccette focacce, mo. Sì, lo so. Vito, this great idea, I have a daughter too. Yes, thank you so much. Il Polish or Biga better at home? Polish. This dough that I made today was with Polish. Allora, niente, diciamo ciao. Diciamo ciao. Ah. Vito, vicino alla pescheria del nonno. Vicino alla pescheria del nonno. Ah, sì, io avevo la pizzeria... Il siciliano, vicino alla pescheria la pescheria Marlon Brando. Poi non c'è più ora. 5 stelle. I watched a video of your 2015 pizza napoletana, your olive oil, 5 stagioni, flour in your dough. Why did you change? Because I find out that Molino Piantoni is much better. Mi saluti, che mi farebbe piacere. Daniel Condello. Ciao Daniel, un abbraccio da Los Angeles da Maestro Di Copelli. Ciabatta, hi maestro, will you make artisan bread in a wood fire oven? Yes, I'm sorry, guys, if I read like this, but so I guess so many comments that goes up, and for me it's really hard to. Ti piace la pizza? Si sta mangiando la pizza, io non so come sono accorto. Tieni, tieni. Piano piano, eh?
Ce l'hai in bocca.
Ti piace? Mm. Ma è tu, ma è tua la pizzeria Los Angeles, vero? Certo. Che c'è? La pizza, buona. Questo è il calzone. È venuto un calzone, mamma mia, fantastico. Can you make a focaccia bread in the future? Yes, she wants all the pizza. Guarda per me. Vabbè. Frozen dough doesn't seem as good after freezing. Does your papa? Yes, that's true. I agree. The dough freezer is not gonna be look like the regular one, fresh, but it's still amazing touch. Il video del lievito che dura tanto tempo, quando lo fai? Sto cercando di farlo, giuri. Sto cercando di farlo questi giorni. Pizza Mix Minus, Calabria, vai. Oh my god, too many comments. Vito, quando fai una bella fauzza siciliana? Non so che cos'è. Can you make a live a link for the bricks? Yes, Vincent. Good question. I'm going to put that under the comments. Okay, guys. Let me read the last comment here. Ciao, Vito, sono grande. La bimba, grazie. Grazie, Francesco. When you make a pizza dough on your summer or winter, have there any tips for weather temperature? Yes. Yes. When it, that's the one of the best comment, and I'm going to answer this really well. Guys, when it's hot, remember, lower down the... Oh, ti stai pulendo? Ok, put more salt and lower down the hydration, so less water when it's hot. When it's cold, more water, less salt. Hopefully that's clear. Grandi amici, cercherò di rispondere a tutti quanti. Guys, leave a thumbs up and thank you and see you at the next one. Ciao ciao a tutti, di ciao papà. Di ciao papà, di ciao. Di ciao. Oh, vabbè, niente, non dice ciao. Di ciao. It's okay. What is the type of flour? And this is 00. What is... Vito, come si chiama la tua pizzeria? Si chiama Provami. Guys, I know, I received so many comments. Saluti da maestro. Grazie, Edoardo. Perfetti. Grazie a tutti, grazie a tutti, grazie, grazie, grazie. What is the type of flour? The flour that I use is 00. Grazie. Bedin, sir, it was a 00 flour. Vito, un canale di vlog secondo me funzionerebbe per... lo so. Per ora già è un po' troppo. Sto cercando di aprire un canale per lei. Questo canale è un sacco, poi vediamo. What is the type of flour? Again, 00. Ciao a tutti, amici. Un bacio da Los Angeles, da Maestro Vito Copelli. Di ciao. No, noi ci andiamo a mangiare la pizza, il calzone e il panozzo. Ciao a tutti, guys. I'm gonna go eat the panozzo. Ciao. Thank you so much for the donation.